When we observe the vastness of the universe using advanced telescopes, one of the most striking realizations is the simplicity that underlies its immense complexity. This apparent order persists even on the tiniest scales when we investigate fundamental particles with instruments like the Large Hadron Collider, LHC. Through these explorations, the behavior of particles aligns perfectly with our established theories in physics. So far, everything seems to fit neatly into our current understanding. However, the quest to understand the cosmos on both macro and micro scales has led scientists to propose two grand ideas, string theory and cosmic inflation. String theory is a complex and ambitious framework that attempts to unify all forces of nature by depicting fundamental particles not as point-like dots, but as tiny, vibrating strings. While it offers a rich tapestry of mathematical possibilities and intriguing concepts, it has yet to yield solutions to the pressing questions of physics, such as the true nature of dark matter or the unification of gravity with quantum mechanics. On the other hand, cosmic inflation posits that the universe underwent a brief period of exponential expansion just after the Big Bang. This sudden growth in size would have been faster than the speed of light, leading to the uniformity we observe today. However, we face significant gaps in our understanding. What happened before this inflationary period, and what fueled such a rapid expansion? There's a great deal of uncertainty surrounding these questions. These two theories suggest a deep complexity hidden beneath the surface of the universe, a complexity that doesn't seem to match our observations of the universe's large-scale structure. Despite its vastness, the universe appears homogeneous and isotropic, meaning that it looks statistically the same no matter where we are or where we look. This brings us to the intriguing possibility that the universe's seeming simplicity could emerge either from our current observational limitations or an authentic characteristic of the universe itself. As we advance our technology and methods to explore dimensions far smaller than we can currently observe or entities on scales much larger than our universe, we may uncover the very complexities we anticipate. Furthermore, if we, when looking out at the universe at the largest scales using sophisticated telescopes like this one here, one thing becomes quite evident. Things are surprisingly simple and straightforward. And when we peer into our world using the Large Hadron Collider, we find that even at the tiniest scales, everything aligns with established physics. No surprises yet. It's a strikingly orderly cosmos out there, from the colossal to the small. Whether you're gazing at the stars or peering into the heart of matter, scientists thought that two big ideas would explain everything. One is called string theory, a massively intricate mathematical framework that, for all its flair, hasn't actually solved any major questions yet. The other is cosmic inflation, which suggests that the universe suddenly expanded faster than the speed of light for a fraction of a second. But we aren't really sure what came before inflation or what powered it. However, together, these two ideas suggest that the universe is super complicated when you look closely and very chaotic from a macro perspective. That does not coincide with observations. On the largest cosmic scales, the universe is both homogeneous and isotropic. This means that no matter where you are in the universe or in which direction you look, the universe appears largely the same. So, either the universe's apparent simplicity might just be due to the limited range of scales we can currently observe, or maybe, as we explore scales much larger or smaller, the anticipated complexity that our theories suggest may eventually come to light. Or maybe the universe really is as simple and predictable as it looks, from its grand scale to the tiniest particles. And if that is true, the clues to cracking some of the universe's biggest mysteries might already be hiding in plain sight, waiting for us to connect the dots. But what if the answer lies not in our universe, but in another? Welcome to Territory. This is your space. Haven't you ever heard of Occam's razor? The simplest explanation is probably the correct one. In the world of scientific reasoning, there's an effective principle known as Occam's razor. Suppose astronomers observe unexplained lights on another planet. Instead of concluding aliens are there.
Now, to be clear, scientists have detected gravitational waves, but coming from events like merging black holes and neutron stars, and despite many sensitive searches, no signs of these primordial waves have been found, with each new experiment ruling out more inflation models. While the inflation theory does explain some issues, like why the universe looks so uniform on a large scale, it also introduces new challenges, like what energy field actually powered inflation. Inflation requires the universe to have very specific initial conditions, but why were these conditions present to begin with? Some inflation models suggest infinite bubble universes. This raises philosophical and scientific questions about testability and the nature of physical reality. So, ignoring the Occam factor here would be basically assuming that there are no simpler explanations. That is something Neil Turok, the Higgs chair of theoretical physics, set out to change. Together with his colleague Latham Boyle, Turok approached a new theoretical model that could address fundamental cosmic questions without relying on traditional inflation and string theory. If we use Einstein's theory of general relativity and the known laws of physics to follow the universe backward in time, we arrive at a point where space and time shrink to a single point called the initial singularity. To make sense of the extremely dense hot state at the beginning of the universe, theorists like Nobel laureate Roger Penrose identified a key symmetry in the laws of light and massless particles. This symmetry, called conformal symmetry, suggests that neither light nor massless particles experience the usual shrinking of space at the Big Bang, allowing them to bypass the intense conditions that otherwise affect all other forms of matter. Imagine you have a stretchy rubber sheet, like a rubber band, with a drawing on it. Now, if you pull or squish that rubber sheet, you might change the size of the drawing, but you're not changing the shape of the things in the drawing. Conformal symmetry implies that the universe could have a similar structure, remaining unchanged no matter how you scale it. This property could mean that rather than being shaped by an explosive event like inflation, the universe's evenness might arise naturally from this symmetry. They propose that the initial singularity, instead of being a one-way origin, acts like a mirror in time. On one side, time flows forward. On the other, it flows backward, like a cosmic reflection. This mirror at the Big Bang aligns with the idea that every physical process has a mirror counterpart, where space-time and particles are reversed, thus following CPT symmetry, a fundamental balance in nature. Imagine the universe as a grand stage where particles act out a play. In this play, three special rules, charge, parity, and time, govern how things behave. Charge is like swapping matter for antimatter. Parity flips the scene as if you're looking in a mirror, and time is running the play backward. Now if you change all three at once, flip charges, mirror everything, and run time backward, the laws of physics stay perfectly unchanged. The universe doesn't break a sweat. It still plays by the same rules, like a well-rehearsed performance, no matter how you rearrange it. Yet the apparent dominance of particles over antiparticles and the unidirectional flow of time in our universe make it seem that CPT symmetry might be violated. The mirror universe concept, however, reinstates this symmetry by suggesting that our universe has a reversed mirror counterpart. In this mirror reality, time moves backward, and antiparticles outnumber particles. This parallel universe need not be a real place, but could be a mathematical construct to explain symmetry at the universe's origin. Their theory also sheds light on dark matter. Neutrinos, which are light particles moving near light speed, spin in a left-handed orientation. However, heavy right-handed neutrinos, predicted to be stable, are possible dark matter candidates, as they interact only through gravity. Using their mirror hypothesis, Turok and Boyle calculated that these right-handed neutrinos could indeed account for dark matter. Basically, the theory suggests that if dark matter is made of heavy right-handed neutrinos, then out of the three types of known light neutrinos, at least one would have to have zero mass. This prediction is being tested by studying how galaxies and other cosmic structures are arranged in space. Observing how matter clumps together across the universe might reveal clues about neutrino mass, helping to confirm or refute this theory about dark matter. The scientists also tackled the mystery of why the universe appears flat and uniform on large scales. They explained this using the concept of entropy, which helps describe how likely certain configurations are.
they discovered that a flat, rapidly expanding universe with a small positive acceleration is the most probable.
Now, to be clear, scientists have detected gravitational waves, but coming from events like merging black holes and neutron stars, and despite many sensitive searches, no signs of these primordial waves have been found, with each new experiment ruling out more inflation models. While the inflation theory does explain some issues, like why the universe looks so uniform on a large scale, it also introduces new challenges, like what energy field actually powered inflation. Inflation requires the universe to have very specific initial conditions, but why were these conditions present to begin with? Some inflation models suggest infinite bubble universes. This raises philosophical and scientific questions about testability and the nature of physical reality. So, ignoring the Occam factor here would be basically assuming that there are no simpler explanations. That is something Neil Turok, the Higgs chair of theoretical physics, set out to change. Together with his colleague Latham Boyle, Turok approached a new theoretical model that could address fundamental cosmic questions without relying on traditional inflation and string theory. If we use Einstein's theory of general relativity and the known laws of physics to follow the universe backward in time, we arrive at a point where space and time shrink to a single point called the initial singularity. To make sense of the extremely dense hot state at the beginning of the universe, theorists like Nobel laureate Roger Penrose identified a key symmetry in the laws of light and massless particles. This symmetry, called conformal symmetry, suggests that neither light nor massless particles experience the usual shrinking of space at the Big Bang, allowing them to bypass the intense conditions that otherwise affect all other forms of matter. Imagine you have a stretchy rubber sheet, like a rubber band, with a drawing on it. Now, if you pull or squish that rubber sheet, you might change the size of the drawing, but you're not changing the shape of the things in the drawing. Conformal symmetry implies that the universe could have a similar structure, remaining unchanged no matter how you scale it. This property could mean that rather than being shaped by an explosive event like inflation, the universe's evenness might arise naturally from this symmetry. They propose that the initial singularity, instead of being a one-way origin, acts like a mirror in time. On one side, time flows forward. On the other, it flows backward, like a cosmic reflection. This mirror at the Big Bang aligns with the idea that every physical process has a mirror counterpart, where space-time and particles are reversed, thus following CPT symmetry, a fundamental balance in nature. Imagine the universe as a grand stage where particles act out a play. In this play, three special rules, charge, parity, and time, govern how things behave. Charge is like swapping matter for antimatter. Parity flips the scene as if you're looking in a mirror, and time is running the play backward. Now, if you change all three at once, flip charges, mirror everything, and run time backward, the laws of physics stay perfectly unchanged. The universe doesn't break a sweat. It still plays by the same rules, like a well-rehearsed performance, no matter how you rearrange it. Yet the apparent dominance of particles over antiparticles and the unidirectional flow of time in our universe make it seem that CPT symmetry might be violated. The mirror universe concept, however, reinstates this symmetry by suggesting that our universe has a reversed mirror counterpart. In this mirror reality, time moves backward, and antiparticles outnumber particles. This parallel universe need not be a real place, but could be a mathematical construct to explain symmetry at the universe's origin. Their theory also sheds light on dark matter. Neutrinos, which are light particles moving near light speed, spin in a left-handed orientation. However, heavy right-handed neutrinos, predicted to be stable, are possible dark matter candidates, as they interact only through gravity. Using their mirror hypothesis, Turok and Boyle calculated that these right-handed neutrinos could indeed account for dark matter. Basically, the theory suggests that if dark matter is made of heavy right-handed neutrinos, then out of the three types of known light neutrinos, at least one would have to have zero mass. This prediction is being tested by studying how galaxies and other cosmic structures are arranged in space.
Observing how matter clumps together across the universe might reveal clues about neutrino mass, helping to confirm or refute this theory about dark matter. The scientists also tackled the mystery of why the universe appears flat and uniform on large scales. They explain this using the concept of entropy, which helps describe how likely certain configurations are. They discovered that a flat, rapidly expanding universe with a small positive acceleration is the most probable.
The theory that associates dark matter with heavy right-handed neutrinos presents a compelling framework for understanding some of the universe's most significant mysteries. One of its key implications is that among the three known types of light neutrinos, electron, muon, and tau, at least one must possess zero mass. This has critical consequences for our understanding of particle physics and cosmology, as the behavior of neutrinos can provide essential insights into the fundamental structure of matter and energy in the universe. Scientists are employing various observational methods to evaluate this theory, focusing on the distribution of galaxies and the formation of cosmic structures. By analyzing spatial arrangements of matter throughout the universe and the dynamics of galaxy clusters, researchers hope to uncover evidence that could validate or challenge the proposed relationship between dark matter and neutrino mass. If dark matter is indeed linked to these heavy right-handed neutrinos, studying how matter aggregates could yield crucial findings regarding the mass of neutrinos, which remains one of the outstanding questions in physics. Additionally, Turok and his colleagues addressed the issue of the universe's flatness and uniformity on large scales. They approached this enigma through the lens of entropy, a concept rooted in thermodynamics that quantifies the likelihood of different configurations in a system. Their findings suggest that a flat universe, which is rapidly expanding with slight positive acceleration, represents the most probable state for cosmic evolution. This perspective contrasts with traditional models that often rely heavily on inflationary scenarios to account for density variations observed in the universe. In a significant twist, the researchers propose that these density fluctuations, typically attributed to inflation, could also be explained through quantum field theories, introducing a fresh approach that may redefine current understandings. However, Turok emphasizes the necessity for further investigation to substantiate these new ideas fully. He notes that visualizing the Big Bang as a mirror is a metaphor that clarifies many of the universe's characteristics, which might seem contradictory to established physical laws. Notably, Turok expresses optimism about potential alternatives to prevailing theories, suggesting that the existing framework of the standard model may limit our understanding, likening it to a straitjacket. He acknowledges that while more evidence is required to back this emerging theory, the exploration of simpler explanations could shed light on complexities that have puzzled scientists for decades. This ongoing research opens up the floor for discussion and speculation within the scientific community and beyond. What are your thoughts on these developments? Feel free to share your insights in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe to Territory for more engaging content on cutting-edge scientific topics.